Let's resume the meeting. The next one, Mr. Holden Chow.
Thank you, Chairman. I speak in support of these two projects. We've been discussing youth hostels for a long time. That was first mentioned in the 2011 policy address. So there has been a lot of procrastination. So I hope that youth in need can be helped in terms of providing affordable housing to them. Now, I would like to ask a question about cost. According to the paper, for the Tongwa Group of Hospitals project, the total sum is $435.4 million, and 210 rooms will be built. So on average, $2.07 million per unit. And for Jordan project, $766.4 million. And the unit cost per unit is $1.36 million. So $1.36 million is a far cry from $2 million. So can you explain the discrepancy here? During the PWSC meeting, we have also mentioned this. It might have to do with the location, the land costs, and so on. And there is a great difference between $1.3 million and $2.07 million. Can the administration give an account of this? The government has also rolled out the arrangements recently for transitional housing. 15,000 units will be built in 3 years, and the government has been working very hard on that, and we have asked the government to identify land for building such transitioning housing units. Can the Undersecretary explain this? Well, we would like to proceed with transitional housing projects and at the same time youth hostel projects. How are you going to strike a balance between the two? And what about the cost of providing transitional housing? How does it compare to the cost of providing a youth hostel unit? There is equally a strong demand for transitional housing. So how do you take forward these two kinds of schemes at the same time? Mr. Chow came up with a sum after his own calculation. For the Tongwa Group of Hospitals hostel and the HKGGA hostel, their structure differs. They have different number of rooms for single rooms and 92 rooms. And for the Tongwa Group of Hospitals, there are 210 units, 118 single rooms, 92 double rooms. So there are more 90 double rooms. And for the 565 youth hostel units in the Girl Guides Association's project, 542 single rooms, 11 double rooms, and 12 accessible rooms. So the proportion of double rooms is lower there. So we can't just do the sums as what Mr. Chow did. Now, in my earlier response to members' question on transitional housing, I said the youth hostel scheme has a different policy objective from that of transitional housing. We focus on young people, and transitional housing is a policy to address housing shortage. So the two cannot be compared directly. And for youth hostels, they are permanent structures, and they can last for several decades. So transitional housing is more of a makeshift nature. So these two cannot be compared directly.
Next member, Mr. Martin Liao. Chair, I support these two youth hostel programs. A question about the Tongwa Group of Hospitals projects. According to the supplementary information provided by the administration, for this project, to avoid causing impact on the Manmo Temple Cluster in different phases, including design and construction. There will be alleviation measures. So we all know that conservation can be very costly. I was involved in the Tycoon project as well. So I know that conservation is definitely not cheap. There will be buffer zone, prefabricated components will be used, and also there will be restriction of work areas and on concussion, power driving, and so on. To ensure that the alleviative measures are taken forward properly, the operator has to engage a heritage consultant to monitor the progress. If there are any changes, it has to be recorded and reported to the Antiquities and Monuments Office. So the $400 million at price tag are the alleviative measures included. If impact is caused to the Manmo Temple Cluster, who will be the one to bear the cost? The governments or the Tongwa Group of Hospitals? Second question, $6.5 million is the consultation fee. So is the cost for heritage consultants included? Thank you, Mr. Martin Liao. I will give a reply and then my experts team will supplement. The difficulty of the Manmo Temple project lies in striking a balance between conservation and development of the youth hostel. We have to protect the statutory heritage. So in the supplementary documents, we mentioned that we will use special hoardings and so on. And also there will be around the clock monitoring. There are many monitoring posts to make sure that sedimentation will not be caused to the Manmo Temple as well as the foundation. Once we have spotted sedimentation, we will stop the work and find a solution. So I will defer to the experts team to talk about the cost. If anything happens, there is a contingency. There is a sum for contingency in the cost. Well, it is very unlikely that any accidents would happen because we have taken very comprehensive measures. Now, I will invite my team to talk about the fee for the heritage consultant. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Liao. The TWGH is very committed to take forward conservation. We have 5 sites with cultural heritage nearby, including the Manmo Temple. So internally, we have an expert group, and we have accumulated a lot of experience in terms of conservation of heritage. Now, in the $400 million funding, it includes a demolition of the primary school, site formation, pile driving, construction of the youth hostel structure, as well as conservation costs and the consultant consultation fee for conservation of the Manmo Temple. They are all included. During the project, we will closely monitor the situation of Manmo Temple with the government's team and the consultant. Besides the alleviative measures mentioned by Mr. Martin Liao and our monitoring measures. When the project begins, we will work closely to make sure that the Manmo Temple is protected. Now, in Manmo Temple, there are a lot of suspended ornaments, for example, plaques and so on. So we consider taking them down for the time being. And also, we will make sure that the construction work would not affect the structure of the Manmo Temple. And also, we carry out regular surveying and repairing work yearly. We will continue this work during the project. As the manager of statuary heritage, this is our obligation. So please rest assured, the TWGH has been maintaining the Manmo Temple on behalf of Hong Kong people for a century. So we will do our best to protect the temple during the works. For a very long period of time, there have been a lot of construction projects near Manmo Temple, including major housing projects behind Manmo Temple. And a few decades ago, when the existing primary school was built, we managed to protect the temple as well. So please don't worry too much. So Undersecretary, concerning the $6.5 million consultancy fee, would you like to give a brief reply? That is the overall consultancy package, including conservation. Next, Mr. Tong Lee Jay. Thank you, Chair. So in year 2011, the youth hostel scheme was mentioned in the policy address. The purpose is to address housing issues of youth. This is a very good policy. So it has been 10 years. Members and I are not happy with the progress. In year 2019, the Federation of Youth Groups has built a youth hostel in Taipo, providing some hostel units. The Polankok one will provide some 16,000 hostel units. So altogether, there are less than 2,000 units. I think most of us would support these two projects. We only hope to see them completed sooner. So altogether, there will be 700 units. Oh, it is not too satisfactory. So I would like to criticize something and praise these projects for something, and I also have a question. I would like to criticize that the timetable is too slow. So for the Girl Guides Association, the site was granted through land exchange. That is a prime site. It seems that the government has a lot of sites, but you are letting them go to waste. Well, you gave us a lot of reasons. The typical reasons are that the operators do not have the skill sets to take forward these projects. But I think the government should be responsible for that. The TWGH site, the school ceased to operate by 2015. For the other side, it has been vacant for a decade. So these were supposed to be good policies, but no results were yielded. Well, during the budget debate, I also said that the government's is giving the public's the public an impression that you are too slow. So you need to think about how to improve your image. So I have something to praise you as well. I like the Tonghua Group of Hospitals projects a lot. The Advisory Council of Antiquities and Monuments and the TWGH has done a lot in terms of design, construction materials, and the construction methods. You have thought it out very comprehensively. So I look forward to seeing the results. It should be it should set an example to integrate conservation of heritage and development. So you are doing a good job in terms of many conservation projects. For this project, besides conservation, we also have development next to it. So it would worth it if you are successful with the project. It will be become a brand. So including these two projects, there are four youth hostel projects. So how many projects do we have down the road? We cannot delay the scheme anymore because we have to help the youth. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Chair, for supporting our projects. Concerning the youth hostel scheme, well, it is not easy because the policy intent is to provide accommodation for youth, allow them to save money, and also make good use of vacant land under the single site multiple use principle. So first, we have to have a non-profiting organization to be our partner, and also we have to have a vacant site through land exchange or and so on. And also, the NGO has to have the will to operate a youth hostel, so it is not easy. So far, we have seven projects. Like Mr. Jay said, the Federation of Youth Groups program has commissioned last year in Taipo, and also the Polar and Cook is providing 16,800 hostel units, which will be commissioned next year. And today, subject to members' support, we will have two more projects. With the funding approved, the projects will commence immediately. The remaining three projects are a youth hostel in Mong Kok, and also the youth hostel by Shin Kong Wu in Yuen Long, and also the youth hostel in Wan Chai by South Asian Army. So of course, we want to see more of these youth hostels. However, there are three conditions, like I said, and we have to have a willing NGO partner. We have to have the site, and then the NGO has to be interested in running a youth hostel. Mr. Jeffrey Lam. Thank you, Chair. I support these two projects. Now, for the Hong Kong Girl Guides Association's youth hostel in Jordan, we have heard different opinions concerning the number of parking spaces. Currently, the government's policy concerning parking spaces is outdated. For modification on buildings and for new buildings, the number of parking spaces provided is still the standard set in the 60s or 70s. Back then, we didn't have high-speed rail. We didn't have so many bus routes. The road traffic condition was very different. However, you are still having the same standard for new buildings or modified buildings. So I really hope the governments can address the issue head on sooner. From the list of public officials present, I don't see anyone from the transport department, but we have been asking the same question many times. So I would like to urge the government to consider seriously the lack of parking spaces. I hope the Undersecretary can take the message back to the administration. We are going to have a lot of developments which will be closely linked to our developments and the developments of the GBA.
If we still stick to outdated policies, then that will become a hurdle to Hong Kong's development. Let me reiterate, I support these two projects. I would like to convey my suggestions through Chairman yourself to the administration. Hope that they can face up to these suggestions. Mr. Lam talks about policy and car parking spaces. Well, I thank Mr. Lam for supporting these two projects. We have heard members' views and concerns on car parking, and we will reflect members' views to the THB. That is the relevant policy bureau to consider. And for the projects on hand, and we have already made improvement in response to members' views. Dr. Chang Chong Tai, second round. Thank you, Chairman. I am not targeting the Tong Wah project, but in terms of the procedures and also conservation of declared monuments, there is much cause for concern, because the government has made a lot of mistakes in the past in relation to procedures, and these are all related to AAB and AMO. And these are youth hostel projects. You said that there is a strong demand for these facilities, but there are a lot of problems with the procedures. Well, in 2015, AAB held a meeting on this. The chairman back then, Lam Siew Lo, said that the projects didn't have to go back to the AAB again after they've looked at it. Well, the design was that there were 17 stories. Now we are having a proposal of 21 story. The consultant said that the height does not differ, but that the height has changed, really. And how come that with so many changes, the proposal doesn't have to go through the AAB again? I think it has the problem rests with the administration, and it has nothing to do with Tong Wah. Well, Tong Wah has been managing a lot of declared monuments over the years. And in the reply, it says that in 2015, there was a report. The consultant from Tong Wah was not the consultant who is sitting here today at the meeting. So we have the reasonable expectation, and that is, well, since the consultant has changed, and given all these changes in the design, well, there's no reason why AAB is not looking at the design again. It's a problem with the administration. The AAB seems to be there just for window dressing. Are you saying this to the public? Any response? Well, I have heard Dr. Zhang's views. We will reflect the same to the relevant departments for them to consider. I know that you feel helpless because it has nothing to do with you. Lam Siew Lo, Andrew Lam, made a conclusion at the meeting, but I don't know about this conclusion. There were also concern groups back then, and And then, well, these case may be, can easily be subject to judicial review. The outline, the OZP passed back then is definitely different from the OZP today. And how can you present such a proposal to the FCR Undersecretary? Do you expect that you'll be challenged? To my understanding, back in 2015 when we went to the AAB, we dealt with the matter seriously. And upon the AAB's request, the Tonghua team did a lot of work to make sure that Memo Temple would not be affected and the cultural ambience there would not be undermined. And a lot of changes or modifications have been made. And we went to the TPB for 2 times. And the TPB did consider the zoning, including the situation of the Memo Temple. I can assure members that we have undergone a very stringent process. Well, you have pressed the third time, so let's hear from Tony Chair first for the second time. I understand there are a number of factors affecting the progress of projects. Well, you see that the Federation of Youth Groups has done their job most expeditiously, and the Undersecretary has raised a number of factors to be considered. You need an interested party. They have the land and they are willing to work on a youth hospital. I understand all these. But then these two projects have dragged on for too long. I hope that you can learn a lesson as to how you can speed things up. Maybe you should be more proactive. You should push things further or faster in a way. And you have given us reasons, and we understand those. But have you tried to learn from experience and try to make amends and improvements? Try to be more positive. And I've said that it has taken too long, and it's been already on the drawing board for 10 years, and it takes another several years before it is commissioned. I hope that you can do certain things to expedite the whole process. I think it's a matter of attitude. And I hope that the administration team can take on a more positive attitude. Now, there are 3 more projects coming up. How many units will be provided? Do you have a ballpark figure now to share with us? And when do you expect these projects to be completed? Let's not wait for another 10 years, or else the youth waiting for their housing will become a middle-aged person, 30 years down the road. For Tonghua project, we spent quite some time because we have to consult the AAB, we have to conserve Memo Temple, we have to go through the TPB processes. And for the HKGGA, because of the design of the new headquarters, they have spent quite some time in dealing with this, and they have to deal with the noise problems and so on. So all these take time. Right now, we have 7 youth hostel projects, a total of 3,400 units have been provided. We hope that more can come on board. But as we explained, we need an NGO which is interested, it has land, and it is willing to provide youth hostel. So anyway, the administration will fully cooperate with NGOs which are interested. Mr. Tony Chair is asking how many units will be provided by the upcoming 3 projects. The initial figure is this. Well, we are still at the planning stage. In total, 800 units. Some are in small, some are large, and some are small units. But then we are still in the design stage. I hope that you can adopt a more positive attitude. For the 3 projects coming up, I don't want to wait for another 10 years before they are commissioned, or else we'll be resorting to other methods to fulfill the need. Dr. Chang, The Undersecretary has just answered me. Well, the procedures have been completed. They have gone to the TPB for two times. I am no expert in law, but anyone can say this. If the TPB is presented with misinformation, then it's a misinformed decision. So you would be subject to challenge. 2015, we saw a different design with different stories. And in 2019, the Town Planning Board made the decision on the outdated, that old design. But we are seeing a different design at the FC. So procedure-wise, it's like they are endorsing a white paper, so to speak. Now, if we pass the proposal, well, that here's my suggestion. So you should actually worship the God in Memo Temple every day, asking God to make sure that there will not be any damage to the structure of Memo Temple. When there are such a big loophole in your procedures and you build a youth hostel there, well, all this is so ridiculous. This is a declared monument, the Memo Temple, and we are providing housing right next to it. Since there are so many bugs, so to speak, in the procedures, why don't you do away with the bugs before you come to FC? The procedures are wrong, and we are talking about the AMO here. Now, let me ask this question. In the event if Memo Temple runs into some problems during the construction period, are you going to stop the construction process or what? Let me reiterate. We have gone through all the procedures properly, the conservation procedures, design, town planning, and so on. We have gone through all these procedures before we went to the panel, the PWSC and the FC today. So if there are problems with the construction, Mr. So has already answered that. But anyway, let me ask Mr. So to address that question again. Thank you, member, for your question. Let me share this piece of information from planning to up to now. The height of the youth hostel has not changed at all, and that is also in line with the development parameter. Now, Dr. Zhang is talking about 18 stories versus 21 stories. The difference is all because is all due to whether we have included the EMM floor. Now, when we raised the Section 16 application with the TPB, we said that including the EMM floor, there would be 21 stories. So I'm not worried that there are problems with the procedures. In Hong Kong, whenever development projects are undertaken, we have to abide by the TB standards. So we've been doing that all the time, the whole way through. I know that time is limited. I don't want to argue here. Mr. So has made a clarification on the height, on the building height. But you haven't given us the reason why the design was different. In 2015, the design was different. And what about the depth of the piles? Are they the same? If it is, then I have nothing more to say. You have changed the design of the building. Well, the old design is that the building will not slant a bit, slanted a bit. So will the depth of the piles be the same? If you said that everything remains the same, then I would say this. Then the consultant, you have to take full responsibility. You will be lucky if there is no problem, but if in the unfortunate event of something untowards happening, then you have to take responsibility.
So any replies from Mr. Chen? I would defer to Mr. Su for supplements. Like I said, Chair, at different stages, we have received suggestions for minor modifications from the government. I don't quite follow what Dr. Zhang mentioned by the building jutting out. According to the government's requirements, we have set back the entire building line so that the space between the heritage bazaar and the pavement is larger. So maybe we are not on the same page with Dr. Zhang in terms of design. However, we will be happy to explain the entire design to Dr. Zhang after the meeting. The project is not different from the plan approved by the town planning board, because we would not do anything illegal together with the Home Affairs Bureau. Yes, I also suggest Dr. Zhang to communicate with the team after the meeting. Any other questions from members? If not, I would. I am aware that Dr. Zhang would like to claim a division, which was agreed by the administration. So now I would like to put the votes at FCL 2021-22-8, Project 42QJ concerning Tonghua Group of Hospitals Youth Hostel Project. Dr. Zhang claims a division. The division bell will be rung for 5 minutes.
We didn't get to give you.
After the division voting and then the next item, then the meeting will be adjourned. Now we are going to vote on the Donghua Group of Hospitals youth hostel next to Manmo Temple. Voting begins. Voting is closed. Please show the result. 31 present, 29 for, 1 against. I consider most of the members present endorse the proposal. I declare that the item is approved. Now let's. Now we are going to vote on FCR 2021 to 22, number 8, 48 QJ Youth Hostel of Hong Kong Girl Guides Association in Jordan. Those in favor, please raise your hands. Those against, please raise your hands. I think most of the members support the proposal. I declare the proposal approved. The meeting is adjourned now. I would like to remind members the next meeting will be at 3 p.m. on the 7th of May. Thank you.